After floating for 120 miles down the Colorado River in Grand Canyon, we finally had a place. We've been looking up at this contact, this great unconformity between the horizontal layered rocks, the Tapete sandstone, and the Vishnu basement rocks. In this Blacktail Canyon, we can come in and actually put our finger right on the contact. Geologists are really interested in contact. So let's find the place where the vertical layers are truncated by the horizontal layers above. If I can put my finger on it, I'm gonna put my finger on, right there it is, right there. And that surface represents a period of time that's sort of unimaginable. These are 1.84 billion year old gneisses, and that's a 0.5 billion year old sandstone. So 1.3 billion years of Earth history is missing along that contact. But now we can't talk too much about what happened during that time in this place, but we can talk about what happened in this lower set and the upper set. I want to talk about the upper set because that's pretty interesting. See, these fragments or quartz are really angular. It looks like they were just chunks of rock laying around on the surface that got deposited. And then look at all this sand here. The sand is coming along. Oh, and it's pinching out. Must have been a little channel where the tidal currents were carving little channels into the basement. And then here's another one of these gravel layers, real angular. And here's a piece of the underlying stuff. So that stuff was being ripped up and deposited in the sandstone here. And it's fairly normal sandstone once you get a little higher, crossbedding indicating currents and depositing beach sands. And fossils, of course, appear in this rock that represent the earliest animal life on Earth, the explosion of animal life in the Cambrian. So this is a place to really unravel several major chapters of Earth history in Grand Canyon.